Cinderella Story. Once upon a time, there was a kind girl named Cinderella. All the animals loved her, especially two mice named Gus and Jack. They do anything for the girl they called Cinderella. Cinderella lived with her stepmother and her two stepsisters, Anastasia and Drusilla. They were very mean to Cinderella, making her work all day cleaning, sewing, and cooking. She tried her best to make them happy. Cinderella's stepmother, Lady Termine, was cold, cruel, and jealous of Cinderella's charms and beauty. She enjoys giving Cinderella extra chores to do, such as bathing her cat, Lucifer. One day, a messenger arrived with a special invitation. There was going to be a royal ball in the palace. The king wanted his son to find a bride. Every young woman in the kingdom was invited, including Cinderella. Cinderella was very excited about the ball. In the deck, she found a dress that had belonged to her mother. It was a bit old-fashioned, but Cinderella could make it beautiful. Lady Termine didn't want Cinderella to go to the ball. She wanted the prince to meet Anastasia and Drusilla. Maybe he'll marry one of them. Lady Termine kept Cinderella busy with chores that could take her all night to finish. While Cinderella was working, the maids and bird picked at her dress. The attic ribbons and beads that the two stepsisters had thrown away. Working together, the animals turned a simple dress into a populous gown. Cinderella was injured when she showed the dress see. No, she couldn't go to the ball. "Oh, thank you so much," Cinderella said to Gus, Jack, and the birds. When stepsisters saw the old ribbons and the beads on Cinderella's dress, they flew into a rage. They rifled the dress full of the beads. Lady Termine didn't stop them. Cinderella's dream of going to the ball was true. Cinderella ran away to the garden to cry. Suddenly, her fairy godmother appeared. With the waves of her wing, she turned a pumpkin into an elegant coach. Cinderella could no go to the ball, but her dress was still burning. "Bumpity-bumpity-bumbo," said the fairy godmother, waving her wing again. Cinderella was now wearing a beautiful gown and sparkling glass slippers. But all this came with a warning. When the clock struck midnight, the magic spell word wore off. At the ball, Prince Charming could take his ease of Cinderella. The orchestra played, and the prince began to dance with the wonderful girl whose names he still didn't know. For Cinderella, the night was a dream come true. Before too long, the clock began to strike midnight. "Goodbye," Cinderella said, hurrying away. "Come back," called the prince. "I don't even know you know your name." As Cinderella fled, one of her glass slippers came off. The prince sent the Grand Duke to find the girl who fit the glass slipper. Lady Termine looked at Cinderella in the attic. but Cinderella's most friends pity her. Then Lady Truman tripped the Grand Duke, and the glass slipper started it. But Cinderella had the others in the pocket and knew it. Cinderella and the prince were soon married. Everyone rejoiced, including Cinderella's most prince, who wore special outfit to the wedding. Filled with joy, Prince Charming and Cinderella lived happily ever after. The end.